Uh-oh. Did I buy a locked board? The problem here is that I haven't used Android so long. I don't really know what to do about this.
I set out to build my own iPhone a couple of years ago, and it took me down this crazy rabbit hole into the Chinese cell phone markets. And ever since, people have been asking me, okay, when are you gonna build your own Android? And I kept saying I didn't want to make that same video again, just building a different phone. But I keep thinking about it, and I realized that I learned so much building that first iPhone, and there's entire sections of the cell phone markets I haven't even explored yet. And I know almost nothing about Androids, but I'd like to learn more because I think that I could do a lot more interesting modifications to them than what I've been doing on iPhone. And I'm curious, are Android phones built the same way? Is it gonna be easy for me to find parts? I think I can figure out how to put it together as long as I can actually find the parts, and I'm hoping that part is gonna be a bit easier this time, given that I've had 2 years of exploring the markets and I speak a bit more Mandarin. I've also been thinking a lot about what phone do I wanna build, and at first I was thinking a Google Pixel, but honestly, almost nobody here has even heard of a Pixel, and so I think it's gonna be really hard to find parts. And then I was thinking Huawei, given that they've been in the news recently, but honestly, I think at this point, that's just asking for trouble. And so I've settled on a Samsung Galaxy S10. Relatively new flagship phone, seems to be getting good reviews, and I've seen a lot of Samsung parts available in the markets. So come down the rabbit hole with me once again. Let's go buy some parts. Honestly, filming in here scares the shit out of me. Nobody wants to be on camera, and so sometimes I have to be pretty careful about it. There are some places in here where I wonder what would happen if somebody found out that I was filming. Getting my ass kicked by a bunch of angry Chinese market sellers, not high on my bucket list. At the same time, I know a lot of people that are okay with it, or at least indifferent. They just don't want me to show their face or their booth location for their own safety.
I'm gonna look for the launch port first. I know from past experience that's often the hardest part to find. I just don't know if I'm gonna be able to find S10 boards yet. As long as I can find that part, I'll be able to find everything else, no problem. Man, this is so confusing. I feel like a total beginner again. What the heck is a G935? I am so lost. I don't even know if these are Samsung boards. Right color. No day off. Even in the right part of the market, even in the right building.
Yeah. You mean your S10吗? Okay.
Market sellers here tend to cluster together not just based on what they're selling, but also their hometown, so it can be super confusing to find your way around.
Yeah. You may have S10. Okay. Hello. You may have S10.
S10.
The logic board.
No.
No. Okay. No one has. Okay. Thank you.
I realized I need to regroup. I need to look up what all these Samsung parts look like so that I know what I'm looking for. And the place that I go for this sort of thing is the Teardown guides that iFixit puts together. And I wanna thank them for sponsoring this video. You know, it would still be my go-to resource, sponsorship or not, but I am happy that they're making it possible for me to spend so much time on this and to buy all these parts. Okay, so here is the Teardown guide for a Samsung Galaxy S10. I just wanted to see what the logic boards look like so that I know what to look for in the cases. Right now, all of the turquoise logic boards are looking the same. I also wanna look up some of the part numbers that I was seeing. A G935 is an S7. An S10 is a G973.
G973. 7793. I don't see that anywhere.
Hello?
What's
the deal?
There don't seem to be any S10 boards. There's hardly any sellers selling Samsung Logic boards at all. It's nothing compared to iPhone. A lot of phone parts come from places like this. I call this place the underground chip market, both because it's physically underground, but also there's a lot of like secondhand and back channel goods that flow through here. People take phones apart and then separate all the parts, clean them up, test them, and then sell them for repair or refurbishing. This sort of thing happens all throughout the neighborhood. There used to be ladies that would sit on the sidewalk outside my old apartment, shucking cell phones like oysters, sitting on little stools. I suspect a lot of the parts also come from waste in the manufacturing process, either stuff that was marked defective by the manufacturer or prototypes or things like that. I'm not sure the big manufacturers are super pleased to know that their parts end up in places like this, but honestly, it's far, far better for the planet than grinding them up for scrap. There need to be way, way more places in the world like this. But the one problem with places like this is if you want to buy parts, you got to wait for enough broken phones to come through to be disassembled to create the supply of parts. I think I'm going to have to give up on an S10 for now and just wait for more people to drop their phones. I guess I'll try for an S9 instead.
Plus.
No plus. 不要 plus. 这个就得.
No F.
Oh, okay. Right. No F. Okay. Only plus.
Wow. Even S9 boards are hard to come by. There's tons of S8 though.
就得没有.
Okay. 这个多少钱? 这个好不好?
好的.
这个没有 ID. Yeah.
没有.
Okay.
解锁，网络锁。
Yeah, okay, 要一个。 Okay, 要这个，好，微信可以吗？
Well, success. I got an S9 Plus instead of an S9, but I think that's okay. I just hope it works and that it wasn't locked or reported stolen or anything like that. I guess now all I need is the other main components, battery, screen, and the case. Those shouldn't be too hard to find.
No.
S9P.
Okay. 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 S9P. 好的，多少钱一个？一个，一个，25。25，好，啊，微信。你好，我想要一个SGO Plus SGOP。那SGO，对，黑色，好，多少？上方要的是。OK，要。
All the iPhone parts have this distinctive look. The Samsung parts, not so much. It's sometimes hard to tell if I'm even at the right booth.
Yeah. 我想要, SGOP.
三星.
对。没有三星。没有, okay, okay.
诺基亚.
Okay, 谢谢你.
Now to get all the smaller bits, the cameras and the screws, and most importantly, the headphone jack. I'm pretty excited about that.
你好. 有没有, SGOP?
Camera.
Camera, yeah. How much for these two? Okay. 你好.
你好.
我要这个.
16, 一个.
Let me see what else you have. Oh yeah, make that too. 有没有这个, SGO? SGO Plus.
Case.
需要多少?
好的. 一个.
35.
35? Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Finding those last few parts is always such a slog. I'm still looking for adhesive and screws and the wireless charging coil.
Yeah. 有没有螺丝？螺丝，Samsung。啊，Samsung，对。这个是，呃，Samsung S 九。
嗯，三送所有。
哦 ，OK。要一个。
要一包。
一对。
If you're enjoying this adventure so far and you want to see more like it, be sure to hit that subscribe button down below.
All right. I think this is everything. Now comes the moment of truth. I gotta put this together and get it to work. Let's just start looking at some major parts here. Now there's a lot of stuff that was already in here. I think it's all used pieces. Let me pull up the iFixit teardown over here. Doesn't seem like iFixit has a repair guide for like the logic board. What I try and do is find the repair guide that goes the deepest, that requires taking out the most parts. I think it's the screen for this phone. Let's start with motherboard. And then you start at the bottom and work the way up. Let's just start fitting some stuff in and see how this stuff fits. This is the headphone jack, so that plugs in there. I know that the D40 goes up, and it goes into that socket there. I guess I should open this. iFixit sent me some screwdrivers to try out. Let's see. Oh, they're in any spots. I didn't realize that. Whoop. Oh, these are nice. Yeah, these are all right. A spudger, though. Pokey pry tool. Tweezers. Looks like I am missing two wires. There's a blue wire and a white wire that should be in here. I think they're the antenna wires. I just forgot to get them. Dang it. I'm gonna have to go back to the markets.
Do you have three things? Three
things? I
want this coin, two. 一个白色，一个蓝色。
等一下
，OK，好，谢谢。啊，老板，有没有三星这个
天线？三星的没卖啊？
没有，OK，谢谢啊。你好，有没有这个天线？这里。
有
，OK。
这个是什么？
这个 S9 Plus。
脱掉了，
谢谢。啊 ，There we go。对。多少钱？
2块。
好。谢谢你。
All right。Two little wires, but they're necessary. All right, the cables are in. I've just got a couple last pieces to put in. And we'll see if this works. Moment of truth. I haven't put the back on yet because I want to make sure it works. Let's give this a shot. First try, baby. Awesome. That feeling never gets old. I've not actually held one of these phones before. This is the first Samsung Galaxy I've held, at least in a long time. Is it locked? Uh-oh. Cameras work. Both cameras work.
Did I buy a locked board?
The problem here is that I haven't used Android so long. I don't really know what to do about this. Can I just factory reset it? Or is there like some equivalent of iCloud locking? I unlike cloud activation. I don't know. Not gonna close this phone up until I get it unlocked. All right, I did a little bit of Googling and I think I just need to factory reset it. Let's hope that works. Okay, that worked.
Wipe data. Factory reset.
Let's get started. All right, we're all set.
Sweet! That was all I needed to do.
Now that I've got it unlocked and fully working, time to put the back on this once and for all. Well, there it is, one finished Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus. It seems to fully work. The iris scan, the fingerprint scan, the face scan all work, cameras work. As far as I can tell, it looks exactly like a store-bought S9 Plus would. But to be honest, this is the first one I've ever seen in person, including in a store. I've just been working off photos online. This video is sponsored by iFixit. Ever since the very beginning, they've been a partner in my crazy phone adventures, even before they knew it. I've always had a laptop just off camera with one of their teardown guides or repair guides as my reference for how to put the phone together. The key is to start with one of their guides on how to take a phone apart and work from the bottom up. And despite having a name that starts with a lowercase I, they're way more than iPhone. They have repair guides and teardowns and tools and parts for everything from Android phones to drones to televisions. I've been using one of their ProTek screwdriver sets in this project, but they also sent me one of their ProTek toolkits, which has come in handy a number of times for things like repairing cameras where I don't always have the right tool. If you'd like a toolkit of your own, click the link down in the description and let them know I sent you. I wanted to add a few thoughts here at the end just about how this compares with the process of building an iPhone. And honestly, this went way easier than building an iPhone. I was quite surprised. Maybe it's just because I'm more experienced, but it felt like, I don't know, there are a lot fewer parts, there are a lot less like sheet metal brackets and things. There's only one size screw, which is amazing. And those mid-frame pieces of plastic, the black plastic with all the screws, those act as a replacement for all of the sheet metal clips that iPhone uses. And there's only three of them instead of like 10 or I don't know, 15. Apple has a ton of random clips that are really hard to figure out where they all go and how they fit in and whatnot. I was super surprised it even worked the first time I tried turning it on. I didn't have any issues with like weirdly cryptographically paired components like the Touch ID buttons in iPhone or the Face ID cameras. There was none of that. It was plug it all in, put in a the cover and a few screws and good to go. The challenging part was really just finding the parts. There are far fewer Samsung parts in the markets and it's just way more confusing. I don't know, iPhone parts look very distinct and my theory at least was that there are more iPhones per model in the world, like there are more units in the world than there are with Samsung, but I did some research and as far as I can tell, that's not actually true. So I don't know, it just seems like there are more iPhone parts here in Shenzhen at least. It feels anecdotally like 50 to 75% of the market is iPhone in terms of number of parts and that all of the rest of the phones, Samsung and Huawei and Vivo and Oppo and all of the rest make up the other, 25 to 50%. So it's just, there are far fewer booths selling the same part. And so you have to hunt around a lot more. This could be a result of the fact that iPhones are manufactured here in China, but Samsung phones aren't. But you would think then that there would be a ton of like Vivo and Oppo parts available. And there are a fair amount, but not anything close to iPhone. So I don't know, I don't really fully understand it yet. That about does it for this time. I'm Scotty from Strange Parts. If you want to see more videos like this one, be sure to let YouTube know by hitting that subscribe button down below. I'll see you again soon.